Let's start our discussion of alkyne reductions with the reaction we learned from our alkenes chapter, where we just take many atmospheres of hydrogen gas and use a metal catalyst. We're showing palladium doped with carbon, okay? And so this is a non-selective reduction, and we're going to go all the way to the alkane. So we go from 2-butyne to butane. If we want to stop at the alkene and we want a sin addition for the alkene, we use Lindlar's catalyst, okay, which is derived from a lead doped compound, okay, and don't worry about the structure. We don't need to know that, we just need to know Lindlar's catalyst. There are other catalysts that can do the same thing, Lindlar's being one of them. So it adds in a syn fashion, forms a cis alkene and stops right there. Okay, and so we end up with cis or Z2-butene. Now, if we want the trans alkene, and it is a true trans, we could name it with trans if we wanted to, because we have hydrogens on both sides that are the same group. Even if we had other groups that weren't the same instead of these methyls here, we could have any groups we want, but as long as we have two groups on opposite sides of the double bond that are the same, we could name as a true trans. I like to use E or Z instead of cis and trans for these, so E2-butene with what we call dissolving metal reduction. Lithium also works for this, so we're a radical donor here. So dissolving metal reduction. So let's look at the mechanism for dissolving metal reduction. So the reaction we see right here. Well, like we said, we have a lithium or sodium metal that's going to donate its radical. We're going to use a half arrow with only a half arrow at the end because only one electron moves here, and then it knocks the, or it forces the pi bond, one of the pi bonds or the triple bond, to break, leaving a lone pair on the carbon. This is In essence, an anti-addition of an electron here, but it's really, we're not adding anything except this electron. But the most stable intermediate is going to be the trans version that we see here. Okay, so we've got a radical next door to an anion. And then we can use our solvent, liquid ammonia. Okay, so this is at very low temperature, below 0 degrees Celsius, around negative 32 for ammonia. Acid-base reaction. And we're getting closer. So we satisfy that anion, we're still left with the radical in this orbital. So then, another one of our metal atoms, plenty of them available, we'll donate an electron to that orbital, we'll spin pair, and now we will form another anion, another carbanion. Our plenty solvent molecules will then undergo another acid-base reaction to form the transalkene.